and preach to the Romans. Amen. And you know what? God give him that desire. Amen. For he's preaching to the Romans as well as to us tonight, because the Romans was the Gentiles, or not the Jews, they were things. So I thank God tonight. Amen. Follow God's desire to preach to the Romans. And the Bible says there in Romans chapter 1, beginning at verse 15, it says, so as much as in me, he said, I'm ready to preach the gospel to you that are at Rome. That was his desire. That's what he wanted to do. And before he left out into eternity, he got to preach to the Romans. Amen. And the Bible says, and he says, also, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus or of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, before that's where he come from, and also to the Greek or the Gentiles. Amen. And church, I'm going to preach on tonight, and I tell you, the church needs it today. The church needs some good old down-home country, amen,
yeah.
Holy Ghost preaching.
Yeah.
Amen. The preaching is the power of God, church. And every time that we need it, I believe it's now, because we need it, amen. Good old power of preaching is because of the time that we're living in now. Church, look around you. The church are falling by the wayside. They're hardly ever having a lot of churches anymore. And when they do have church, it's a dried up service. There's no anointing, there's no power. And church, I want you to know something. I thank God. God hasn't changed. The gospel hasn't changed, but people has changed. Amen. So the time that we're living in, we need some good Holy Ghost preaching in our churches. Amen. Because of because of the time that we're living in. Let me tell you something, church. Paul told Timothy that, can you imagine, this was over 2,000 years ago. And he told Timothy that there was going to come, amen, a time of a falling away. And there was going to come a time that people would not want to hear the gospel. I mean, they want to hear the gospel, but it has to be so watered down and so pleasing to the ear, amen, or they won't come, amen.
Yeah.
But church, let me tell you, that will not save you.
Right.
That will not deliver you.
Amen.
That will not cause you to be an overcomer. Paul said, because of the gospel is the power of God. But the time that we're living in, amen, that we need it, church, and the churches need to get back, amen. And God needs to send some Holy Ghost-filled preachers and pastors, amen, that will preach under the power and the anointing of God, and let the preaching come, let it land where it should land. Can I hear an amen? But the Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1 through 5, Paul said, Timothy, I charge you. Now, Timothy was a young pastor, he was a young man, and Paul was an overseer of Timothy, and that we need some overseers like that in our churches tonight. So as we look into 2 Timothy chapter 4, beginning at verse 1, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word, be instant in season and out of season, reprove, rebuke, and exhort with all long suffering. And church, I believe we need to get back to the time, amen, where the preaching will cause you, amen, to want to step up and do what God wants you to do. This is what the Bible says in verse 3, for the time will come. Now, church, we're living in that time right now. Even when Paul was telling Timothy, it would come, and it came in Timothy's time, and it's here, but it's got worse now, church. It's because people are with itching ears are heaping themselves to churches, amen, and they don't want to hear the truth. And church, the only thing will set us free is the power of the gospel and the truth of the gospel. The Bible said the gospel will set us free. Oh, I thank God I'm free tonight. How many glad they're free tonight, church? Oh, give the Lord a hand clap, church. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. They said, but watch in all things, if your affliction do the work of evangelist, and make full proof of thy ministry. Now, church, let me tell you something. We need to get back to that. And church, we tell you, we don't have many evangelists anymore because the church are not having full enough people even to support them. But church, I'm here to tell you, the pastors can do the work of evangelists. This is the kind of evangelist evangelistic message tonight, church, because we need to get back some old-time Holy Ghost preaching in churches that will cause people to change. Church, let me tell you, if you get saved and you don't change your ways of life, you have not been saved. Because the Bible tells us when we get saved and Jesus lived in us, we become new creatures. Old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. When I got saved, I was changed. I said, I was changed. How about you? Glory to God. Oh, give the Lord a hand clap, church. I feel this tonight. It brings deliverance to all kinds and all forms of life. See, that's why Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel because it's the power of God. It will change your life, church. And I'm here to tell you, if you're bound by Satan, the gospel calls you to be free. If you're held captive, and then the gospel calls you to be set free. Are you listening tonight, church? Yeah. And the Bible says in Luke chapter 4, verse 16 through 19. Now, church, we need to see this. Now, these are the words of Jesus. And there was no better preacher, no better teacher than Jesus Christ. And this man was anointed the power of God. We need to have the power of God upon us, church. And the Bible said, and Jesus came to Nazareth, for he had been brought up, and in his custom was he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, and stood for the reed. And verse 17 said, for there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. When he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Amen. To preach to the gospel to the poor. And church, there's every time that we need to start preaching the gospel, amen, to the poor. Church, we tell you, take a lot of these salaries away from some of these big-time evangelists and these big-time pastors and put them on a place where we live, amen, just like the people in the White House. I mean, they say they don't have enough. John, $174,000 a year, and they say it's not enough. And Pastor John, $75,000 and $80,000 and $100,000 a year, and they're not teaching and preaching the gospel, having one service a week and everything, and think they're doing okay. Let me tell you something, church. This is not what God said. He wants us to preach the gospel to the poor with the anointing of the Holy Ghost and power. This is what Jesus done. He said, I've come to preach the gospel to the poor and set the captive free. I tell you, church, the gospel will set you free, glory to God. This is what it says. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recover the sight to the blind, and to set at liberty them that are bruised, and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Church, I'm here to tell you, I thank God that Jesus was willing to stand up and proclaim the gospel, amen, because he knew that he was the king that was to come, and there was people, their hearts and lives were crushed, and they were under heavy burdens and everything, and the devil had a lot of them captive and bound. But church, let me tell you, he said, I've come to set you free. Amen. And church, he come to set us free tonight. We are free tonight because of the power of Jesus, and because of the gospel was preached, amen, that he said, come, amen. And when we come to him and give our lives to him, glory to God, we become set free. Amen. And church, let me tell you something. I believe Jesus is the only way. I believe he's the truth. I believe he's the light. And no man can come unto the Father. There's no 15 or 20 ways to heaven, and there's no 15 or 20 ways to Jesus. There's only one way, praise God, and that is Jesus. He's the way, he's the truth, and he is the life, and the gospel will deliver the captive. He will then cause us, the brokenhearted, our hearts to be mended and healed because of the gospel.
Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord. See, the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 18, see, we're living in this bad time. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 18 tells us, for the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness. Oh, yeah. And a lot of people are going to perish because they think that the cross of Jesus and that Jesus is the way of life, it's going to be foolish to them, and they will perish. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. But it said, but unto us, the preaching unto us, or but unto us which are saved is the power of God. So the Bible tells us the gospel, because of the power of the gospel, it saves us. Amen. And thank God I know I'm saved.
Amen.
Which, like I said, I believe it was there a while ago. When God says you're saved, you're saved. When God says you're healed, you're healed. He said when you're set free, you're set free. That's why God is, and God ain't going to go back on his word. And number three, church, I thank God. Paul recognized this, amen. And if we look into the book of Acts, now church, good old time Holy Ghost anointed preaching, amen, will cause joy. What the church would be just in this community right here. If churches get back to the anointing of the Holy Ghost and power of preaching, it will cause joy to this community. And God said, Phil got into a place to Samaria that they needed some joy. They needed some deliverance. They were in captivity, and that God was going to set them free. And church, it brought joy to them. The Bible says in Acts chapter 8, verse 5, then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. The church, the Bible says Philip was full of the Holy Ghost and faith, and he went preaching on the anointing of God. Now, he wasn't an apostle or nothing. He was just a servant, and God sent him down there to preach the gospel. I'm here to take God and send anybody, amen, a time or place to preach the gospel. If you're filled with the Holy Spirit and under the power of God, he'll send you to places. And he sent Philip down there, praise God, to preach the joy and bring joy to that city. God can bring joy to a church. He can bring joy to a home. He can bring joy to a community. All we've got to do is get the old-time passion, old-time gospel preaching, and church, to let it flame and let's lay it down the way God wants it to be laid down. And he will save souls. It will deliver souls. It will bring people in captivity, out of captivity, and it will break the bonds and go into God. I'm about to get happy now, and he'll put joy in your feet. We need to get back to have some joy in ourselves, church. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
That's what the Bible says in verse 6. And the people with one accord gave heed to those things which Philip spake, hearing and seeing the miracle which he did. For unclean spirits cried with a loud voice, came out of many that were possessed with them, and many taken with palsy, and they were lame, were healed, and there was great joy in that city. I'm telling you, church, you get some good old time preaching and under the anointing of God's Holy Spirit, and it will cause joy in the church, it will cause joy in the community, and it will set people free. Too many people are held captivity. And church, let me tell you, it's time that we get free. It's time that they get in a place, amen, that they don't want to hear the old song, watered down half a minute or whatever sermon, and half-baked sermon, but get under the spell where the anointed preaching is, and preach the word of God, and let the word land where it's supposed to land, because Jesus said he will not come back void. I'll give the Lord a hand clap, church. And I'll say the last for the best. Good old Holy Ghost, anointing preaching in a church will clean us up. It'll get us ready, church. See, God is coming back after a church without spot, without blemish or wrinkle. He's coming back after a holy church. And church, let me tell you something. The preaching, amen, I'm not talking about a watered-down sermon. I'm not talking about something that will cause you to have your ears itching, pleasing, amen. Paul said, reprove, rebuke, then exhort. But we got everything turned around. We try to exhort everybody before we reprove and rebuke. Jesus said, reprove, rebuke, then exhort. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5, in closing tonight, verse 26 and verse 27. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26 says, that he might sanctify and cleanse it, he's talking about the church now, with the washing of the water by the word. See, the word, the preacher will wash us. The word of God is like water, he washes. And what Paul was saying, well, if you know anything about the temple of God, you know there's a big basin, amen, that when you go in and apply the blood, then you go to the basin, this is where you wash before you go any farther. And church, let me tell you something. We need the good old Holy Ghost power preaching in our churches, that it will clean the church up and get us ready for heaven.
Amen.
Come on.
That he might sanctify and cleanse it, which means the church, with the washing of the water by the word, that he might present to himself a glorious church. See, preaching will cause us to be a glorious church. I'm talking about a body of Christ. I'm talking about believers in church. We need to get under the spout and stay under the spout of churches where there's some good anointed preaching that will cause us to be washed and cleanse us and quit worrying about being watered down. Church, let me tell you something. I'm not going to go to a church that, amen, it's watered down and they don't believe in having service, because I want to be clean. I want to be sanctified. I want to be ready for church. I want to be ready for God to take us up, church. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
That's why you don't have a lot of churches, a lot of people in churches today. You start preaching words and laying down the word to them. I'm not talking about being hateful. I'm not talking about being mean. I'm talking about this. Jesus preached more about hell than he did heaven.
Right.
Church, we need to preach some hell. We need to preach some fear of God. We need to tell them that if you don't live right for God, you're going to hell. Can I hear an amen? And God, God didn't save us to sit on the seat and do nothing. He saved us that we could be a light to a lost and dying world, and we could be the salt of the earth, that we could cause people to come to church and give their lives to him.
Amen.
Oh, give the Lord a hand clap.
Amen.
Verse 27 said that he might present to himself a glorious church, not having a spot. Could you imagine just a spot? A blemish. You couldn't even hardly see it with your naked eye. Only God could see that spot or blemish. That's how it is, church. Let me tell you something. The Bible says that in the time when he comes, amen, that only just a few of the elect will be saved, because, church, I'm here to tell you, God has come back after a bride. He's come back after a church without spot, blemish, or wrinkle. And we need, amen, have that blood of Jesus applied to our life and have everything washed and cleansed by the blood of Jesus. That he might present him to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle, or having any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. And church, that's why God gave us preaching. That's why God gave us the Holy Spirit. That's why God gave us Jesus sitting on the right hand side of the Father making intercession for us. Amen. That's why he gave us grace. Amen. I don't believe that once the grace, always the grace. And I believe if we mess up, we need to get back to the altar. Amen. We need to go back to the altar and make it right again. Amen. Not covered up or trying to hide it, give it to Jesus, because he's all seeing God. Amen. Sees everything.
Amen.
Church, we need to get back to the old time, glory, gospel, Holy Ghost anointing preaching. Amen. And the churches are not doing it today. The churches are not doing it. Amen. I know we don't have a big crowd and everything. Church, let me tell you something. You start preaching the word of God, they'll start thinning out.
Yeah.
I've been a man one time where I worked with. They run about 500 people. And he said, you know what, Bob? He didn't call me pastor or minister. He said, you know what, Bob? He said, my pastor won't let you preach in that church. I said, that's probably right, because I preached the sanctification and everything. I probably did a bunch of them out.
Yeah.
Amen. That's the truth. You start preaching what God wants you to preach. Amen. And I tell you, Bob says choose his way or there's no way. Amen. And I thank God tonight we chose the right way.
Amen.
Bible says narrow is the way that leadeth to life, and few there be finding.
Yeah.
Broad is the way that leadeth to destruction.
Yeah.
But thank God we're on the narrow way. Are you on the narrow way tonight?
Amen.
You know why? Because you've got the gospel.
Yeah.
The gospel will set you free and cause you to live right for God, because it will wash you and it will trim you.
Amen.
I tell you, we need some trimming, church. Even the pastor needs some trimming sometimes. Amen. Because I tell you, you can't be fruitful. You take an old pear tree or apple tree, whatever, and just let them old trees grow every which way. After a while, them old apples and stuff will become knotty and everything else. You couldn't even do nothing. You start whacking down some of them old dead limbs and thinning them limbs out. Amen. That's what Jesus tells us. Amen. And it will cause you to have good apples. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
You'll have some good fruit. But sometimes they will cry, oh God, he cut this, oh God, he cut this, oh God, he cut this, oh God, you're hurting me, God, you're hurting me. He said, that's okay, son, that's okay, daughter. I'm going to make you be more fruitful.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's stand tonight. Praise God.